And the Foreign Minister.
Well, I'm always impressed by what you know. What we plan. And you, the President, sit there, and there are about five ways to talk to you. And then after they've got two of them,
Before we can start the meeting and have the others in, there will be several waiters of photographers, news photographers will be coming in. Chair over there.
As the sportsmen say, in great form.
Thank you very much. I do feel.
Russia is by Simi, this is the truth, please.
Russia.
Russia. The fact that the weather is like this is not our fault.
Maybe you were experimenting with something
about it. Yes, not mine.
They promised that tomorrow the weather is going to be fine.
Yes, in fact, before the day is
over.
Я сегодня сказал, что пока не установится хорошая погода, мы уедем.
I said today that I'm not going to leave Washington until the weather is fine.
We've been promised sunshine in the afternoon.
Да, обещали даже сегодня после обеда, что уже солнце.
Just wait,
please.
Thank you. The reporters are on the offensive. If I tell everything to you, what am I going to say to the president?
And they would be out on the lawn taking these pictures all at once.
Обычно, если когда так много прессы, то мы были бы на балконе, они бы снимали нас из сада одновременно.
In view of the rain, we thought the only kind thing to do it this way.
Но так как дождь идет, мы считали, что просто нужно пощадить прессу и пустить их внутрь.
Президент будет встречаться с товарищем Горбачевым, там, я надеюсь, будет хорошая погода.
When you, Mr. President, meet Mikhail Gorbachev, I hope that the weather there is going to be fine, really fine.
Mr. President, how important are today's talks in determining whether the Geneva summit will be successful?
I think it's all part of the same thing.
Mr. President, will you be meeting with the foreign minister alone without any aides today?
It may be a few moments before we move over to lunch.
Еще, кажется, одна-две волны.
Мы были в Нью-Йорке, там хорошая стояла погода.
Throughout the time that we spent in New York, the weather was fine.
Yes, we have been having beautiful weather.
Да, действительно, погода была хорошая.
Очень интересно проходит юбилейная сессия Генеральной Ассамблеи.
And the current anniversary session of the General Assembly has been very interesting.
Хорошая, высокая представительность.
The representation is at a very high level.
I understand from our own reports here that, I hope I have it correct, that this storm, the hurricane, is yet to strike New York, but probably will be worse there than it was here.
Mr. President, thank you for your consideration in having it indoors today.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
the interpreters will switch and we'll...
It's going to be okay.
All right.
Shall I start over? Well, in preparing for this meeting, I had a chance to look at how the United States is portrayed in your press. It's not a flattering picture, but and I raise this not to make you uncomfortable, but to make a point. This meeting and the meeting that I will have with Mr. Gorbachev in November provide an opportunity to get a more accurate view of each other. I want you to get a true picture of who I am, what I stand for, and what I want to accomplish. And I'd like to get the same from you and Mr. Gorbachev. I think we need to get beyond stereotypes, to talk frankly about our differences, to explore constructively what we can achieve together between now and November 19th, and then after the Geneva meeting as well. When I met last year with Mr. Gromyko, right here as we are now, I discussed my view of the world and of our two countries' place in it. And I'm sure you're familiar with what I said then in that conversation, so I won't repeat myself, but I would like to emphasize something that I said at that time. Our philosophies and political systems are very different and will remain so. But at the same time, we live in this one world together. And I think must handle the competition between us in peace. Neither of us will ever allow the other to have military edge. But if we're ever going to clear the air, reduce suspicions, reduce nuclear arms, there will never be a better time than now. I'd like to discuss several points. Why the Soviet Union should feel threatened by us when we have never started a war and never will. I want to explain why we can see your military build up and your attempts to expand your influence in the world as threatening to us. And this is why we're rebuilding our own strength. We feel we must defend ourselves and to make sure that a war is never conceivable. But we need to go beyond the discussion of our rivalry. I would like to share with General Secretary Gorbachev our hopes and our plans for our peoples, yours and ours. We both have much to do at home, and if we understand each other's priorities better.
I come from a land where there is a wine growing. A very small country, Georgia, Soviet Georgia.
The stock market
closed at 10 a.m. this morning.
Биржа в 10 часов утра сегодня закрылась.
The bond market closed at 10 a.m.
Биржа на облигации тоже закрылась в 10.
Oh, wait a minute. The recommendation was made and to close the stock market at 10, so the stock market did not open at all.
Так что биржа, нет, была рекомендация закрыть в 10 часов биржа, что она не открылась.
The point is, the hurricane is expected to hit New York between 12 o'clock and 2 o'clock.
Потому что как раз ураган будет проходить над Нью-Йорком между 12, между полуднем, значит, и двумя.
So sometime now in the next hour and 45 minutes, if it hasn't hit already, it's supposed to hit there.
Так что если ураган уже не дошел до Нью-Йорка,
the best thing that's ever happened to the United Nations.
Может, это самое лучшее, что вообще случилось для Объединенных Наций.
Это вчера на торжественном заседании Совета Безопасности, господин Шу, вспомнил.
Secretary Scholz remembers yesterday at the commemorative meeting of the Security Council, the first statement.
The meeting of the Security Council had not yet begun. By that time, everyone